That's more like it. Hey guys, this is the Lil Forky Mark II by The Hidden Dare. We're inside a carrier. I just think it's a good place to put a forklift. I'm gonna give you guys a quick walk around. I like the round shape of the hull of the forklift, by the way. So the forklift costs 2,363 PC with 159 blocks. Alright, let's see here. And that's a lot of magnetic plates there. I'm guessing these pistons will lift the whole thing. And that looks really nice. A simple grill with a spotlight here. Nice use of the cylindrical column block there. Nice detailing by the creator. This is what made this forklift kind of unique, by the way. The round shaping of the body. Here's the rear lights of the forklift. That actually looks kind of nice as well. Nice attention to details with the stripe of paint job here. I'm not sure why the forklift needs 6 wheels to the top of the forklift here. More decorative elements. That's the conveyor for the cockpit of the forklift. And gyroscope here. Small cargo container. And we get the batteries as well as an event controller behind this bar here. Let's see what's to the bottom of this thing. We get a connector. I'm not sure why the panel is shaped that way. Those are batteries, right? Is that a drive shaft? That's a nice attention to details considering the whole thing is covered by a panel. Alright, I guess that's pretty much the whole exterior. I'll look at this attention to details with this bar here, by the way. Let's drive the forklift now. The pistons are kind of in the way. A rather simple toolbar. Automaton timer up. I'm guessing those are for the pistons. We have mesh blocks on this thing as well. I'm not sure what that's for. Oh, there we go. Wait, what? Why do we need to use timers for this? I'm guessing the mesh blocks are there so that this forklift can, you know, operate in artificial gravity environment. That's pretty nice actually. Whoa! The forklift is pretty agile. The speed limit is 8 meters per second, but you know, that's kind of understandable. Yeah, the handling is pretty well configured for a confined space like the internal hangar of the ship here. Alright, let's carry some stuff. Let's say that we got a damage fighter. Then, you know, we want to move this out of the way, right? There you go. Lift the whole thing. Lift the whole thing up. I think I get why we need to use the timers now. You see how there's like multiple steps to these pistons here? That's actually really smart by the creator. I think this thing is too heavy though. What the hell? Look at how tall the arms of the forklift are. Hold on, I need to carry something lighter here. Maybe a gyroscope got detached in accident, right? Wait, what? How is that gyroscope still attached? Oh, that's because we're in station mode, hold on. There you go. Alright, maybe you have some kind of an external modular cargo system thingy. And you need to place this somewhere, right? Maybe up here? Oh no, no, hold on, hold on. Yeah, there we go. Close enough. I'm a logistics genius. So you know, the forklift would be very handy for something like this. Intimidation posture. Let's say there's some kind of a workplace incident. You know, maybe you're not paying attention. Let's see how well this thing can go downhill. Come on. I'm gonna try to control with... The forklift arms can actually be used to... We can stick ourselves to the walls. Hold on, let's see how this thing can actually... how well this thing can actually go downhill though. Oh, not again. Hold on. Alright, for real, this time. This is gonna be a long video. I need to gain some speed here. The speed limit is only 8 meters per second, that's why, hold on. I think this should be fine actually. There you go, I'm gonna turn off the magnetic plates, come on. Get down. And there we go. Alright, let's try to survive. Come on. Come on. I can smell victory. Well, with enough skills, anyone can get a forklift certification. That's actually pretty amazing though. The overall shape of the forklift is, you know, it's like really compact and small that you can easily maneuver the forklift while it's falling. That's pretty impressive. I'm a master of my craft. Since we have the forklift, right? Come on. Oh, hold on. Alright, let's see how well this thing can deal with an enemy base. Fire. Ooh. Come on. Destroy. Wait, are we winning? Really? Oh, what the hell? Oh, that was a crazy lag there. Oh no, we lost the turret. Alright, I'm gonna use the turret for shield. And I'm gonna see if we can, you know, go underneath the enemy base. Oh, this is a good thing though, because the whole thing is protecting us from the front. Come on. Oh, I forgot to increase the speed limit. It's fine. Almost there. This is kind of scary actually. I'm not sure what's gonna happen once we pass this hill here. Are we still getting shredded? Oh, we actually disabled. Wait, did we disable all their weapons? Really? Huh. Oh wait, there's actually still a weapon. What the hell? Yeah, but the forklift actually destroyed two of the three enemy turrets though. I'm not sure why the top turret is not shooting at us. I think I understand why. Because the large grid that we're carrying is technically disabled. The enemy Gatling turret cannot target our forklift. Well, I'll still consider this a victory. But yeah, well, I mean, you know, it's not really that functional or practical for actual survival. Because, well, practically speaking, you're probably better off with a flying vehicle that can tow things. But well, if you want a forklift that can also carry weapons, then I guess this can be a good vehicle. Say, that's Lil Forky by the Hidden there. You guys can find the link in the description below. What an interesting vehicle.